Hey everyone, this is my industrial ripped out. 3 weeks I had it done, today it ripped out. On Sunday I was out riding, and of course when you go out riding like on a hack, like down the roads, through up there, I went up into like forest and that. And my mum rode my horse Buddy, and I rode her friend's horse, and my little mare, and she's obviously a little bit of a part Arab, she's a bit mad. And we were galloping, and Buddy like took off, he went off ahead, because Red's quite a lot smaller, she had to follow on behind a bit. She was going pretty fast. My hat was too big, I didn't have my normal hat because my mum had been borrowing my hat, and it was too small for her, and she put it in the garage. And then obviously she put it in the garage, like in a box or something. We like keep like saddle cleaner and old hats and old bits of broken things, and that we don't particularly need but might still find a use for, like, because you like that with horses, you have like something you've got and you might be able to make use of it for something else, cause, you know. And then basically the hat caught on it, ripped it forward by about that much. If you want me to, I'll make another video with some photos of how much it had ripped. It ripped right through and it was bleeding. I didn't realise it had done that. I thought it had caught on my hair or something, and it was just a bit sore because it flopped down and hit my eyebrow as well. Which, by the way, I changed that over to a nice little short acrylic one. Quite nice. And then basically I went and then I got home and a couple of hours later looked in the mirror and thought, no, actually I was sitting on the bed and I was thinking, that doesn't feel quite right. Looked in the mirror and thought, that doesn't look quite right. Because it had ripped quite a lot. And then obviously overnight and then yesterday, I'd cleaned it and it had moved a bit closer to the surface. Migrated. And then today it migrated a lot. So I went back to the piercing studio and the woman had to look at it and she was like, that hasn't been placed right, blah 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 blah. And like basically what I said, she had another good look at it. She looked at the top and said the top one's perfectly healthy and fine. I'll show you that in a minute because that one's saved. The top one's nice and safe. That one's okay. But the bottom one, it's literally either going to scab over and fall out, or collapse your ear, or it's going to force its way out, or of course rip out. And rip out it did. Here's the bar for it, the industrial bar. That's quite long considering I have really small ears. It was basically sticking out about that much. Do you remember if you looked at my other videos? It was sticking out about that much. Not very good. And obviously that was catching up because my hair's right down to my bum when I went down and push it out and that. It obviously snag. And the hat on it, the riding hat's come down into like a Y shape here and to clip underneath here, and it had obviously been sitting there, my hair's very thick, my hat flung back, lifted the underneath of it, ripped forward, and my hair tugging on it hadn't helped. I'd obviously not been sleeping on that side and obviously very careful with it, but today when I got home it had migrated out so much. It was literally, the skin was like, you could literally see, it was like a very thin white layer of skin, and then it was the bar, you could see through it, pretty much like you can now. It's like, it looked like a little bit of you know, like you see the white plaster bit there, you get a clear bit of plaster, a bit of that covering the bar, that's all that was holding it. It's going to come out within 2 days, if not, and it obviously did come out now. happened just under an hour ago. I was going to update about it being ripped out, but obviously update about it being rejected, well not rejected but migrating and ripped anyway, so I thought I might as well just wait until it comes out. A lot of people do have this problem with industrials because they do rip, tear and that very easily. Once they start to break skin, they're gone. I'm going to go back and get it redone again. I could either use this bar or I think I'm going to get a shorter one. and I think I might go that way, but you get them done through the back at the top, because you won't be able to see very easily. You can do them like, oh dear. That way, so the bar's sitting upright in your ear and it goes through the thick back bit here, goes through this bit, sits at the bottom. That would be a really good hold for it, and it couldn't rip out very easily unless it came out of the top, but I'm going to ask for it to be done out the back of the top as well, so that would definitely hold. It could not rip out unless it was literally grabbed with, I don't know, something and ripped straight out my ear, but that would be very difficult. The bar's still a bit long for that. You see, it's like a massively long tongue bar. I'd say it's probably about 32mm. The smallest they do is 20mm. But a lot of people just use 26, depending on the small ears, but it depends on the size of your ear. Some people have to go up as large as 55, 56mm, which is going to be about that. Then again, it depends on the placement and stuff. Yeah, so hang on, let me get this ball screw back on and I'm going to show you some of it. I'm not going to take the plaster off because it's hot, it's angry, very angry. I'll move in here. You can see my two cartilage on the side there and there. You see my ears like nice and pinky white, it's nice and flat and soft and normal. And then on this ear, you see that shaded bit there? It's swollen into a lump, you can see the size difference. And yeah, that little bit up there. I don't want to be playing around it too much, you can just see the ball from there. It's a little tiny mini barbell. It's ever so cute, it's so sweet. Sitting in there holding the top when I open, it's 1.6, which is good, and that's stopped bleeding now. That was where it was ripped out. Got this little plaster on to hold it, keep just as much as to keep it covered, just to keep infection out of it and keep the hair and stuff out of it during the night and that. So obviously people leave them open, but it's too fresh to just leave tomorrow, leave it open all day during the day, because I'm not going out or anything. When I go out or like go to bed, I'm going to keep it covered, because if you've got hair clips or anything, they can fall on it, rip it open, get caught in it and stuff, and I don't really fancy having them tug my ear open anymore. It was very painful, but not like agony or anything. It was not like it was getting pierced, it was a lot worse than that. It was like really sharp pain, but it was like, you know, like, it's the pain where you have to get catch your breath back a bit, you know, like, and you just feel, you know, you're getting really hot and really stressed by it. It was a lot like that. It wasn't like a screaming pain or anything, it was like really hot, really hard going pain to get the industrial bar out of it, because obviously it's fresh. It was difficult to get it out the top one as well, but obviously easier than the bottom. I got it out the top and the top had swelled into a lump as I was pulling it out, and I pulled it out and I was trying to put the barbell through at the same time. Pulled that out, and as I was pushing the barbell through, a layer of skin had formed over the top of it and had to pop it through the skin. Oh, that was horrible, and it was taking me ages to get it right through, because it was obviously pulling the ball up, like the lump of skin around it up, as I was putting it through, and it was making it swollen. I think the bump's gone down a bit now, it obviously will. That was a problem, that one. It was itching while I was doing it as well. I was thinking, why on earth is that itching? Why is it trying to heal up now? What's it doing? Like, really itchy, like really funny, like it was healing up itchy. It was annoying as I was trying to pull it out. But it's probably for the better, it's out now. It's just too much. It was going to cause me a lot of problems. And I'm riding again on Thursday with my friend, so if it had lasted until then, I put my hat on and I was out riding and it ripped out, I wouldn't be able to do very much about it, and that wouldn't be good. So it's better it's like that now. I can just keep it covered. The top one's not irritated at all by my hair or anything, And the nice purser said she thought it looked very healthy and clean and that. It was fine, it wasn't really, it bled a little bit underneath, but that was because that one had obviously ripped it, not that a bit. But it's healed up, and I'm just going to leave that little barbell in there. I'm not going to change that one at all, just leave it. I think it looks quite cute, like that. It looks like it's difficult to see. There it is, you can see it. That looks quite cute, actually, don't you think? Cute. I might actually get one done on this side. I think that looks really sweet. But yeah, it's such a problem. It's been cleaned out, obviously. I've cleaned it up, and warm water and cleaning solution, dried it off, dabbed it, bandaged it up. And surprisingly, it hasn't upset these earrings. Them ones are old and them ones aren't. They're not on cartilage, so they're not going to be. They're quite calm. That one's the back one's a little bit sore about it, but it would be because it's going to come down the air a bit. Yeah, so industrial piercing ripped out. You just got to be careful, honestly. It's hit and miss things. Some people have really small ears and they rip out. Some people have them for 50 years, don't rip out. They could rip out at any time, obviously. If you've got really long hair, or if your hair isn't cut into shape round here, you've got really thick hair and stuff, and obviously wearing a riding hat, or then big earphone things that people like, what are they, skull candies or something. They're obviously going to irritate it and rub it, so you just got to keep things off. I've got it all, got my hair cut. That's why it looks such a mess, because I've got loads of clips and stuff in. And it's like got a big gripper, and then I think it's called a crocodile clip or something. I don't know the name of it, but that's like holding the hair back a bit, which is good. It's just keeping the pressure away from it all. Try and sort it out a bit. Yeah, so I'll just leave it. And I'm going to make my update on my septum piercing now. So I'm going to go and make a new video. Bye guys. Oh, by the way, leave me any comments, inbox me, anything, if you want any information on it and that. But honestly, if you've got one or want one, take this as a warning. They might look nice, and I will get one redone, if not two redone. But they are very, very risky. If you're going to get one done, take yourself quite a short barbell, about 26mm if you've got small ears, 26mm at 1.6, not a 1.2, a 1.6, 26mm. That's 32mm, and that's obviously far too big. The size of that thing, big to my hand. That's quite large. I think that's a 32mm, it might be slightly larger. But obviously take a 26mm with you, because that'll probably be the one that you're getting done. They might take some money off as well if you take your own one. They could well end it. I think they charge a tenner in the piercing places from them, so they might take a tenner off it. I won't take your own one, just in case. If they say you want this really long one, say I'd really rather have the short one. And if the pierce is very good, they will understand and they will put it in for you. And that's just a little tip. Anyway, I'll see you guys later.